from Japan. And I hope, thank you very much for gathering in Wednesday. I'm so poor at English, but I will do my best. Please associate me. It is my Penguin Robot Team TRYBOTS. The first, please watch this movie. This is the movie to get swimming with the real penguin in the Japanese aquarium. So many penguins is there, but I think real penguin don't like my penguin. This is the top side. The fastest of this robot is about 2 meters per second. It is not so. It can be possible to diving. It's about 3 meters. Ah, thank you. And also come back to the surface. And now, it is popular by the children. We have many science events for the children in Japan. Okay. And we have the small one. It is more smaller than this, but it is a little bit slowly. And we are the team of TRYBOTS. We started from 2013 when I was a high school student. And we go to the technical high school in Japan. So, and we measure the mechanics. So this is the graduation project for us. And we are continuing to develop this robot until today. We ordinarily development at Akihabara in Tokyo. So please contact me if you come to Japan. Hey, this is history from the 2013. Sometimes we get some work to show our robot to the event. And I have the big event this summer. We will show the penguin for 2 months in the science museum in Hamamatsu in Japan. We are developing the penguin robot for healthcare and virtual reality. This is penguin, you know. Penguin is so cute and fast in the water, and everyone loves the penguin in Japan. How about Singapore? And it's an important point, I think. Besides the man, the only animal working with the 2 legs. So I think that we familiar with the penguin. So if you can swim with a penguin, it is image. But I think that everyone fun and happy to sing together the penguin. This is a movie with the children. So everyone in the first is scary, but the first part they are so happy. Oh my God. it is an event that designers even in Tokyo. They like hanging to have them. One of children's dream is swim with a penguin, I think. But isn't an easy thing to swim with a real penguin because that is dirty and it is impossible to go the sea or the river to swim with the animal. I think it is possible to swim with a penguin robot. It may have the effect of animal therapy. So we are holding more workshops with penguin, with child. This is the workshop. We are held a workshop. The children make this small robot. It's made by Tamiya's motor. And the second mission is a tele-existence as a virtual robot, but a virtual reality. This is the newest penguin robot. This is a virtual reality case. We can control this penguin robot remotely, and the controller is shaped like a penguin. So when you flapping the penguin robot controller, you can control the penguin located in my lab by the internet. So the tele-existence is mean and tele-control and existence. That's you. But the tele-existence difficult point is the duration between the real and you control. And this thinking tele-existence make avoid the duration because you are swimming in the water. This response time is ordinary. You have the response time in the water. So tail distance in the water is less duration you feel than the land. The tele-existence of inland. Sorry. So you can feel less duration than other VR system. And ordinary tele-existence is that you will be the humanoid robot. Is the ordinary tele-existence, but then this project, you can transform to penguin. If this technology comes to practical use, you can transform yourself into a penguin and go out play the sea from here. And when you are shaped like a penguin, animals will be really avoided you. And when it isn't shaped like a penguin, you can go to the place where you can go as a human shape. So this is the newest version. It can turn quickly. By the legs and head turn to this. The flipping system is so difficult to turn in. Okay. So you have another movie. This is a movie from the water. This is my robot. In then, that is controlled by the customer. Come to the show. It is from far from 5 kilometers. Then the customer turn his head, this penguin turn the light. And this robot has a camera on his head. So this is Penguin Robot's camera. So we are live casting this video to the different place, and we will see by the head mount display. Okay, let's shift to the mechanics. We developed a flapping system. This is to not use a sub motor. It is an important thing of us. Do not use sub motor cause the efficient energy, and it goes do not. We use only DC motor to the flapping system, and we cannot waterproof that mechanics, because if we waterproof the entire things, that is so dangerous. So we have to waterproof so smallly as possible. So we can use a waterproof box in the some microcomputers in it. Okay. This is the structure. Box with in it a computer, put in the one board, and flapping piston also put into the board, and DC motor is put in the board. The board and the 3D printer's cover to sandwich this board. It is a so it is so simple structure. This is important to the underwater robot, because we should waterproof some components, so we have to more simply if we can. The detail thing, and the other detail thing, please see the real one. And we are supported in a small factory in Tokyo, so we create the this made by the aluminium, and we designed this and we ordered to the small factory in Japan. Yes. Okay, so it's my English so far. Please page on me. Thank you so much. Oh, please touch her.
Alright, guys, so anyway, everyone, let's give now another round of applause. Okay, so right now we open the questions to the floor. Does anybody have any questions for now about Mechatronic and we? Anyone? Just give it.
This is the version 6.6.
Yeah, photos of your previous. Uh-huh.
This is the first type of robot when I was in high school. This waterproof system is so poor. We into the just Ziploc. So difficult.
Is it the same size as this one?
Yes, the little big.
Bigger.
Yes, because the flipping system is bigger. The second one is it is this. And we are into the box, but and the flipping system and DC motor in it. The waterproof system has the 3 versions. This is Nao system, and we have the waterproof box in it. It is more efficiently than this one. And this is so dirty, but it is collect things.
Yes. So which parts were? So you can explain.
This. The one. Polypattern. Now this is wire because for the demo.
There's space here as well. Just come forward.
With a degree of ripple. Mm-hmm. And now we make stuff by the butterfly system, but I think more efficiently mechanics of it. This is a stopper.
Stopper.
Yeah, polyurethane stopper. This is the end of this. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So it propels up and also down,
or is it just by the test?
When you
put the start, it moves
forward.
When you put
it down, it also moves forward.
Yes. Is it only down, then? No,
only
down and
down and up.
Down
and up?
Because
the
price system.
So the swing.
Yes, same.
Does it go backwards?
No,
How fast? Now it's
So when you put it with other penguins, are they disturbed by it? Do they run away or do they come in?
The real penguins?
Other
the male penguins, yeah. It's scared?
No, it's scared, but don't like.
They don't like it.
No, it's scared, so...
Funny sound.
Yeah.
Funny sound.
Yeah, funny sound.
So noisy.
But in this case, the main motor only drives the flippers. So the head actually is driven by these two. The head is driven by these two motors. Mm-hmm. Is it?
Yeah.
Left,
right.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. 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 Cool. Very cool.
When this is the sound side. Because this motor is not fast. So we should turn more degree than the other penguin.
Mm. Which component do you build first? Do you build the body first, then you build the head and the flippers later for?
What do you do first? What do you do this one first?
The
body first or the head?
The body first.
The body first. Because I think the early prototypes didn't have a moving head, right?
Yeah.
It was just straight head.
Yes.
Right? Only later on that it moved.
Yes.
How do you maintain the balance?
Right.
Yeah.
It is balanced because I have the big thought on this on his back.
Okay.
Yes. Yes. This is called a big float. Float.
Oh, so the float is in the body. Yes. But how do you keep the balance?
Balance is not
here. Is there a gyroscope?
No.
Or IMU.
By the structure.
By the structure. Oh.
And also by the distribution of the weight.
We know I have it.
The balance of the
I have we put on the balance. This will put to the water. Heavy as water.
How do you get the control signals?
It has a Raspberry Pi in it. So we, in the past, I access this to the computer. And then,
for the programming?
Yeah.
So when you want it to go left or right, how do you send the control signal?
By the controller, it has the dial sensor. So when you do this, the dial sensor senses the lift, and this signal to send this.
I see that this is for the power supply.
Yeah.
How does the signal get to the connection? How is it plugged?
In the Ethernet cable through this.
So you've got a second cable?
It's a second cable.
Right.
To the loop.
Okay. Not this one, it must be another one.
Yeah. This one is for some reason. Okay. Yes. We are separate with the battery because this system is for the DC motor. When this system is drive by water, it can be seen.
Are these water type connections?
Yes.
Water resistant connections.
This is a waterproof connection. But it is not good.
Silicone gel, what's it called? Silicone grease inside.
Uh,
It's a little bit heavy. It's a little heavy. With the participants at the back, are you able to see the penguin? I think it's worth coming forward. There's the space here. Just come forward and take a look.
Okay.
Yeah, okay. Okay. You don't need to be shy.
Power
just
bank.
Just
power bank. How? Is it a power bank?
How is power? It's power battery to the smartphone.
Any other questions that we have for now about the robot penguin? Anyone?
What was most difficult?
The question is, this is so big by the water, but sometimes it can be alive. When I try this, but I think the sea water is more dangerous for them. Yes.
And how much do you think you've spent across these years, you know, just building this prototype, like all the different versions that you keep?
The time?
The cost.
Cost?
Of about building up all the different versions of.
About $700 or $800. Yeah. So mostly for some.
So the most expensive part of the penguin is the machining of the metal component. That's the most expensive.
Yes. And this is so vacant. This is so vacant. So I have the more 5 or 6.
Each is how much?
35.
Can I ask, why is there like duct tape near the tape? Yeah, why is it duct tape?
On the
stick the foam. Yes.
Oh, okay.
This is so... This is not sticky to this fabric. So now I coil them. Yes, but it is not good.
Because the water would still kind of cause the glue to come off, right? Over time, so we got to replace that. Have you thought about like adapting the design into something else, like now that you have fine-tuned it, like instead of a penguin, can you apply to sea turtle or other designs, other animals, apart from like penguin? Like, can you change it to a turtle? Have you really thought about evolving it?
The first, in my middle as a high school student, we have to do something to make a robot. So I like the underwater robot because my senior, like the senior made the underwater robot before. So then I went to the aquarium to take up some
inspiration.
Yes. So when the penguin swim so fast. By the feeding system, so I want to know how do they swimming by the feeding system. The fish robot is some people researching now. So we choose the penguin robot.
Is it because of a streamlined body shape?
Yeah.
Why don't you choose a dolphin instead?
Why do you choose a dolphin? Because it's got the human body shape, isn't it? Yes, this shape is so extremely. This skin is the wetsuit.
You see a scuba diving suit?
Yeah.
This is for a wetsuit, isn't it? It's for a wetsuit.
Yes,
wetsuit.
For a
wet. Wetsuit.
Yes. Yeah. Yes, wetsuit.
Can I just ask that the blue color like servos, these are like waterproof servos,
yes.
Is it? So have you had any issues with the reliability of it? Has it spoiled before? Yeah, or is it, you know, really very robust as in all your prototypes, the servos, waterproof servos have always not had an issue, unlike, you know, water going in, popping out, you guys verify. But what about the servo? Has it always been very reliable, or, you know, after a number of hours, you know, water will get in or something like that, or because of the pressure, you know, depending on when you dive deeper, you know, there's greater pressure, so has the servo failed before?
This servo is strain.
Very high strain.
Yeah,
okay.
Very high strain. So
no issues before. No problem.
Yes.
No problem.
No
always
problem.
Always works.
Always use this servo.
Always use this servo.
Yeah.
But then this sailing is not so good sometimes, is it? Or
yes.
Is it this like box that you've tried so far as is quite good? Maybe the previously you had Ziploc,
yeah.
And maybe other boxes, but then eventually you went on to this one and you haven't had an issue with the waterproofing.
This case is so good before, but it's maybe sometimes not waterproof.
Oh,
still. So it's so big, this rubber. This rubber is so big. So, but this servo is so strong, and we have never break this. So we use this servo in another in the beside this case. So the polar, the waterproof is most difficult. And this case is not much to.
In this case, what will you be building next? How will you be? What is the next plan for the penguin?
For the penguin next one, we want to put in the artificial intelligence in it.
Artificial intelligence.
Yes, and to follow the. Follow the children and previous children, and then I want to add in the patrol in the pool or sea. So it is now by only controlled by ours.
But the program is
such
a program available to be installed into the Raspberry Pi.
In now we're developing.
You are developing.
Yeah.
When would that be ready? When would that be ready?
it's a difficult thing. But I want to do the first prototype within this year.
Within this year. Yeah. Wow, cool.
But you need sensors for that, right? Because what sensors will you use for the way to follow the
children? I think by the camera first. Yeah, the micro sensor
yes.
Is existing for the on the land.
Exactly. I was thinking underwater.
Yes,
right.
Underwater sensors so big and expensive.
Right.
So it is this bad point on the for the loss control.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, one last question in the interest of time. Okay, opening to the floor again. Anybody else have questions for now? No one? Alright, of course, let's give now. So, for every one of you who has more questions for now or wants to work, please go ahead. Of course, so this one's the end of today's tech talk. My name is Jason Gabriel. So for me, I'm the 13 monitor group and we're going to stay over here. And if who is the first time here at having a
quite a few of you. So in any case, if you're interested for a lab tour, I'll be at the piano at the, just over the other side in 5 minutes. So in any case, my name is Liu Yang. Have fun, everyone. Just enjoy your life. Alright? Thanks for coming through.
Facebook.
Yeah. I can give answers
by the
text. Okay.